describe what it's like being in a lineup like this and doing what you guys are doing. You described it as kind of being like in basketball on a fast break offense. Is that a apropos description? Or he just kind of
I'm processing that one right now, and I'll say yes.
Okay.
Fast break. Well, you know, here it is. I mean, it's the little things, right, with this offense that can get you excited. You look at, you know, I use the Trey Phelps at bat, right?
Yeah.
Hits a moonshot, you know, fair foul, whatever. We don't have a camera, whatever, you know, who knows. But it's 3-2. Guy comes back, throws a good quality slider. It's real easy at that point to still be sped up about that and chase that slider and strike out. He takes it, takes his walk, gets there, you know, stuff like that. And then you get Kolby Branch up to the plate, mm-hmm. and then bases are loaded, and the guy's got to come to him. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're doing what we're supposed to do when those situations are happening right now.
I don't know how else to ask you any question about Charlie Condon. He goes out and makes that kind of diving catch in center field. You push him out there for his first start, and that's what Charlie does, it seems like.
We play Charlie a lot in center in the fall and early spring. And, you know, I've told everybody, and I've told you guys a lot, I mean, it's underrated how good of an athlete he really is. You look now, he's played third, he's played first, he's played all three outfield, and he's played all three of them at a high level. And, you know, I was asked earlier just a second ago about potential playing the other. I said, well, he did play some short and second in the fall, but I don't anticipate us doing that unless something crazy happens. But, no, I mean, he's a great athlete. It was a nice play. There was a second or third inning. You know, he lays out, and that's big. I mean, just to keep him off the bases, let Maragna keep going. Maragna threw the ball extremely well tonight. I thought all our guys did. I challenged him tonight. We finally had a good outing. We didn't walk anybody. And it's like I told him, hey, we can all live with it. Their little freshman got off two really good swings on pitches that weren't that bad and hit them out. Good for him, you know, whatever. But you can live with those as long as we're attacking the strike zone and making them do it. And that's what you saw tonight from the pitchers.
You can't do much better than what they did. Like you mentioned, zero walk, 17 strikeouts. That was.
We attacked strike zone, attacked it with multiple pitches, got ahead, and then, you know, induced some chases, and that's what you're supposed to do as a pitcher staff.
Do you have a plan for Charlie, like, as the week starts, or is it like every day you fill out the lineup card and where do I want to put him in position-wise?
The beautiful thing about having him and then, you know, Slate playing third and then Trey Phelps now, guys, I mean, look, Trey's played third, first, he's played left and right. He's played four positions, so you look at it, it's more about pitching matchups. Who do I need? What other bat do I need to get in that lineup to face that guy? And with the flexibility of those guys, then I'm able to move it around.
He already was very established when you got here as a player on the college scene. Did you need to, like, sit him down and talk to him about your plan to be able to play him so many different spots?
Yeah. That was one of the first things we talked about. I just said, Charlie, look, man, everybody knows you can hit. When we were in here last year when I was – you know, at LSU and we played, I was like, wow, this kid's a good athlete. I didn't realize, you know, because all we do is watch video on the swing and breaking down. And so the first thing I talked to him about when I got here, I said, Charlie, we're going to help you drive your stock and showcase how good of an athlete you are. And it's going to help our team as well. And so, yeah, he was like, yes, I want to play everywhere. It just keeps him fresh and it keeps him, not that he needs to be locked. He's always locked in, but, you know, just keeps the energy with him.